Hey everybody, welcome back. I'm often asked, what is data-driven attribution and how does it work? So today I'm going to show you exactly what a data-driven attribution model is, why you need to be using data-driven attribution. So it's a tongue twister if you're running Google Ads or if you're doing any kind of digital marketing, and I'm going to show you how it actually helps you be more profitable and where to set it up. So let's talk about really how it operates. Let's say you have a business and you're doing marketing and you're getting traffic to your website. Things are going good. You've got customers coming in. And so what you do is what most people do. You think you know how customers find you and you want to be sure. And so you ask your customers, hey, how did you find out about us? And they tell you. However, we found that customers' answers to that question are wrong 89% of the time, because multiple searches from different devices, that is the norm of how people are shopping. And they typically are not going to think through that thought process of tracing back every single step that led up to it. They will just kind of give you the big picture that comes into their mind that they last remembered. So let me give you an example. There are now a total of 37 searches that are done online for travel related purchases before somebody actually winds up booking a trip. 37 different searches on average. If you think that's a lot, a total of 139 searches on average for a car purchase. 139. And so that usually involves so many different touch points. There's a lot of data there, a lot more than that car dealership as you roll in the lot saying, hey, how did you find us? Well, I found you on Google. I found you on Yelp. It's much, much more complicated than that. And so 74% of customers use different devices. So that brings a whole layer of additional complexity in trying to really track and attribute to who that customer was and where he logged on from and tying it all together. So with all those searches, how do you really know which marketing channel is working for you and how much credit you give each one? And the reason it's important is that marketing is expensive. And so there may be investments of time, money, and effort, and maybe a combination of all of those in these different marketing channels. And by you knowing what your effectiveness is, what your rate of return is, it's very important data for you to be able to make marketing decisions to scale your business, to add budgets, to remove budgets, to shift things around. But really, the magic is in pouring jet fuel on the things that are working the most for you. You have to know, and you have to have that data. It can really help you run a much more profitable campaign using data-driven attribution Google Ads campaigns. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. So let's get rolling with it. Hey everybody, I'm Richard Cruz and my agency tests and we develop cutting edge Google Ads strategy every day. And in these videos, we share with you the best tips and the best strategies to help you hopefully get better results with your Google Ads and your digital marketing. So hey, before we get rolling too much more, if you're interested in getting more information as we roll out these videos, click that subscribe button so that you get alerted. So in Google Ads, you have a default attribution model and it's called last click conversion. That's this guy right here. Tracking is defaulted to that last click, but the problem is when you have the default in Google Ads and it's giving you data on the last click only, it does not tell you the entire story. Last click attribution gives 100% of the credit to that last click that the person took before coming to you. So before converting, actually. So if somebody took 5 different visits to get to you, that last click is so not representative of the entire story. Last click is really, really simple. So if you don't need very much data, or if you're like an emergency type of service, like a plumber or emergency vet, it's pretty safe to say that one click is probably going to be pretty typical. I got you on the line. It's 11 o'clock at night. It's an emergency. I need you right now. I'm not doing a whole lot of research on you and going back, waiting multiple visits. I need you now. So in situations like that, you're probably going to be really, really solid with just using the default last click, and you don't need all of the different touch points like that example I gave you in travel, or I gave you, for example, in car, or even if you have 3-4 touch points, that's enough where you need to really grab more data and you need to know what's working for you. So when you have multi-touches, you know, how do you know how much credit to give? And that's where the machine learning comes into place. It differentiates it from all of the other models here. All of these guys are fixed. They have very, very different goals and they work really well. They have different advantages. Time decay is one that has, you know, particular advantages that we like to use sometimes. But this one here is where we're going to really, really focus on today. And that's where data-driven attribution comes into play, because it helps you understand that entire customer journey and how they really got to you. The thing that I find interesting though, and here's what is just a mind blower, 31% of Google Ads managers are not using attribution in their campaigns. That just blows my mind. Do not understand it, because you cannot get to the right levels of profitability and performance if you don't have the right tracking and you know where your business is coming from and all the touch points and how they got there. You get so much of a better picture of how your marketing channels all work together by using it. You get so much better budget allocation. You get a better understanding of the customers every step of the journey that got them there. So for example, Jane, she finds you on Google Ads while she's at work on her lunch break on her mobile phone. Later that day, you know, she's at her office computer and she goes back to your website and she's checking you out a little bit more. 3 days later, on the weekend, she's no longer at home, no longer on the office computer. She has more time, and so she searches for you organically, and then she goes back to your website to search further, but this time she is on her laptop. And then finally, at the end of the weekend, it's Sunday night, before the weekend is over, she's in her bed, and she may be on a mobile device or maybe on her laptop, and she sees one of your remarketing banners pop up, which is brilliant, by the way. If you're not using remarketing, let me just put a big old plug for remarketing. It works. You got to make sure that you're using it. So she sees your banner. I got a little sidetrack there. She sees your banner pop up. She clicks on that banner, and she goes back to your website, and Jane buys from you. There's a lot of complexity because there was multiple days spanned. There's multiple IP addresses or multiple locations. There was multiple devices from her laptop to her mobile to her work computer and multiple marketing channels that all work together to get to that purchase. And so your data-driven attribution model is the glue that tracks every one of those touch points. It is the machine learning that understands the role of each marketing channel, that how much of a role that they played, and it assigns a value to each point intuitively and automatically. What is not to love about that? So to change to a data-driven attribution Google Ads strategy, go to your Google Ads Manager account. Go to the tools, conversions, and then change the conversion model. So let me show you how to do that. Go to the tools, and then you hit conversions, and then you'll come in here and now edit settings. And in here, you could see what we're using is time decay. And then you go to the drop down menu here, and then you can switch over to data-driven attribution, and now you can be set up in your, you know, ads account for data-driven attribution. Very, very simple to update it and to have it switch over. Now, if you have ads in the past that maybe you paused because they weren't getting the results, you might try to just go back and unpause, you know, some of them and then optimize them for data-driven attribution and see if you get any different results. And folks, that's my overview on data-driven attribution. And I hope that you learned at least one thing today in this video that can help you with your Google Ads. And if you did, do me a favor, leave that one thing below in the comments. It helps me know what I'm doing right and helps me create better videos later on. And if I can be a help in your marketing, call or message me at WSI Priority Media. Don't forget to give this video also a big thumbs up and share it and subscribe so you're alerted of future training videos like this. Thank you so much for watching.